Slim Shady, better known as Eminem, is arguably the greatest rapper of all time. By arguably, I mean probably, most likely, even as far as indisputably, the greatest rapper of all time. Why is this the case? Because Biggie and Tupac are dead, and Eminem is still putting out music. Eminem is so good, he embarrasses the competition. And by greatest rapper of all time, I mean greatest lyricist as well. He exhibits showmanship of linguistic auditory crafting for exalted aesthetics. He illuminates the beauty of our language. He's also a savant of a showman and an exhibitionist. Like a verbal contortionist, Eminem rhymes 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 or more syllables with another 6 or more syllables several times in a row, frequently in full sentences. It's important that we ignore race in this situation because it has no bearing or context within the scope of what we're talking about. Race doesn't equate to achievement. And just because I look white doesn't mean I necessarily am advocating for a white rapper. I think it's irrelevant. I'm just talking about craftsmanship. The argument that I pose for Eminem as being the greatest rapper and lyricist of all time has to do with a number of factors, including complexity of rhythm or syncopation, alliteration, multisyllabic rhymes, allusion, personality, intonation, speed, breath conservation, harmonic melody, energy, emotion, talent, work ethic, body of work, inventiveness, groundbreaking, inspirational, mastery, sense of humor, clarity, evolution, superiority, tenacity and overall likeability, artistry, beauty, breath, body of work. When I listen to Eminem, I'm sitting down and listening to and appreciating 16 bars for those 16 bars itself. Just measure for measure. Just like alcoholics in AA take one day at a time, I take one rhyme for one rhyme. For example, on Eminem's most recent album, he rhymed, "The only way you're ahead of me is alphabetically, because if you diss me, I'm coming after you like the letter V." And that's what I'm talking about when I talk about appreciating artistry for itself. Just appreciating 16 bars for 16 bars. I have to admit, I already made this video before, but it included music that was copywritten, so I'm gonna apologize ahead of time for having to read the lyrics myself so that this thing can be published. Haters have been saying Eminem should retire, and why? What's the point? If you don't like him, you can always just not listen to him. You could always just do that. What's the point of telling somebody to retire? If he wants to put out more music, that's his prerogative. And the point is, the man can still dominate songs. I mean, Rap God came out recently, and that was a work of mastery. Early Eminem was joke-oriented. The later Eminem, talking about the most recent Eminem, is more dynamic. I used to be able to rap along with the songs. I can no longer do that with any of Eminem's songs. While he still has punchlines, just like he used to, but it's less jokey. It's more syncopated and rhythmic. He has more speed. It's more technical. He's a technician. He's rapping in a way I can't do. Most people can't reproduce this type of music, this type of rhyming that he's doing. The speed is savant level. The syncopation is extremely complex. Listen to this short piece of music that hopefully won't get this video banned, as Eminem goes from a triplet rhythm, a rhythm in threes over a 4-4 time signature. The rhythm is as you would count 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and... If you put triplets over that, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, dot, 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 dot. That's what he's doing. He goes from a triplet rhythm, which is typical of old Bone Thugs and Harmony rhyme scheme. And then he transitions into extremely syncopated 32nd notes, which are fours. So it goes from threes to fours. Hear the difference between the triplets and the syncopated dotted 32nd notes. Eminem always has content, complexity, depth, and timing. What I love about Eminem is he comes out with rhymes like, there's several different levels to devil worshipping, horses' heads, human sacrifices, cannibalism, candles and exorcism, animals having sex with them, camels, mammals, and rabbits, but I don't get into that. I kick the habit. I just beat you to death with weapons that eat through the flesh, and I never eat you unless the meat looks fresh. I got a lion in my pocket. I'm lying. I got a nine in my pocket. And baby, I'm just dying to cock it. It's as beautiful as Shakespeare or Edgar Allan Poe. Or it's only fair to warn I was born with this set of horns and metaphors attached to my damn umbilical cords. Warlord of rap that'll bash you with a 2x4 board and smash into your Honda Accord with a 4-door Ford. But a mortar dropping an acapella to chop a fella to mozzarella worse than a helicopter propeller. There. Dropping an acapella to chop a fella to mozzarella worse than a helicopter propeller. You get four syllables rhymed with four syllables multiple times in a row, where you're getting 16 rhymes in the matter of 4 seconds. It's a nutrient-rich, a deep, rich rhyme scheme. I mean, you're getting as much, it's concentrated rhyming. You're getting the most number of rhymes in the shortest amount of time that rap has ever produced. Two elements allow Eminem to bend or make flexible the sound of words. First off, he always matches the vowel sound of a word. Something like big, ditch. Big and ditch aren't perfect rhymes. They're near perfect rhymes, but they both have that eh sound. Big, ditch, him, syphilitic, minimal, explicit, fictional, indispensable, digital, cricket, critic, minute by minute, within, illicit, illicit, intricate, prohibited, cinnamon biscuits, eh. That's the way he rhymes, with the vowel sound matching the vowel sound, and then kind of sponging the consonants there. Eminem also hides phonetic manipulation in highly intricate and syncopated rhythms. The purpose of this video today is actually to take us back to an early Eminem song called I Am. The purpose of this video is actually to take us back to an early Eminem song called I Am. And the reason for that is because I don't think it drew the full appreciation it deserved. I Am by Eminem was written in anapestic tetrameter. And that means it's a rhyme scheme where it's short syllable, long syllable. Da da da, da da da, da da da. The reason is this song is beautiful. I think this is arguably the most well-crafted rap song in history. I Am by Eminem. The beauty of this song is in anapestic tetrameter, meaning short, short, long. The beauty of this song is the anapestic tetrameter. Da da da, da da da, da da da. And when it's not that, the reason I bring this up is because when you have a short syllable followed by a long syllable, it's called iambic. And he uses not only anapest, he uses iambic pentameter in this song. So, iambic, I-A-M-B, nobody had ever noticed that I am is actually written in I am, I-A-M-B. In I am, if you listen to it, Eminem actually pushes the rhythm by hitting the beat slightly early, a fraction early. He's actually a fraction early with the syllable to the downbeat, which gives a lot of power to the song I Am. It actually, it's empowering. And if you don't believe me in terms of the power of acoustics, watch this. This is the power of acoustics. This is water levitating. Now that you've watched water levitating, let me impress upon you the fact that Eminem says these syllables a fraction early, before the downbeat, pushing the rhythm, and it has a palpable effect on the listener. Listen to the verse and listen to him push the rhythm slight. He is always slightly ahead of the downbeat. Do you hear that? How he's pushing the rhythm? He's one step ahead of it. It's energetic. It's inspiring. It's commanding. This is why I'm making the argument for Eminem being the greatest rapper of all time. And now that Eminem has set the bar so high, have people responded in kind? No. I'd like to go back to give you some of the most garbage lyrics of all time. Here's some of the competition Eminem has when it comes to lyrics. This is the garbage that contemporary music is producing. This is why I'm impressing upon you Eminem as being a savant, as a lyricist, and an artist. Because up until Eminem, we have had to deal with a lot of garbage. like the Killers with the song Human. I'm down on my knees searching for the answer. Are we human or are we dancer? There is no stupid questions besides this one. Humans and dancers are not mutually exclusive. Actually, all dancers in history have been humans. The circles, like the sphere, dancer is inside the sphere of human, like Lesotho in South Africa. Dancers and humans are not mutually exclusive. Are we human or are we dancer? You didn't even use correct grammar. Why do we as an audience tolerate this type of garbage? Then we have Nirvana with All Apologies. What else can I say? Everyone is gay. Is that why you blew your head off? Because Courtney Love didn't have a dick? I don't know. And I'm pretty sure you didn't mean gay as in happy, because there's no buckshot in anyone's happy skull. Kiss in Burn Baby Burn. Oh baby, I want to put my log in your fireplace. I thought you just wanted to kiss, hence the name. And by the way, I think you wear too much makeup, Gene. P. Diddy, back when he was Puff Daddy on his song Can't Nobody Hold Me Down, said, young, black, and famous with money hanging out the anus. My first thought is, Puffy, you don't know how to do cocaine. The dollars go in your nose, not the other holes in your body. And the second thought I have is, I know what I would get you for Christmas, a wallet. There's better places to keep your money than your anus. Liz Phair in the song Flower said, I'll f*** you till your dick turns blue. Why don't you blow me till my dick is f***ed?